I don't accept politics as African community is looking at it. Politics is not the way it's being done in Africa. It's quite a dirty game all around, the way the African community has looked at it. Because politics just means an activity that leads to leadership, leading the people that God has created. But here in Africa, it is a whole platform for stealing, lies, and all sort of things. So as I'm concerned, I don't talk about politics. I'm a man of God. I am a man of truth. I am a leader God has made. I don't do politics. We have come with a drastic change to change the nation of Cameroon with truth and then morality. We are coming to, first of all, change the mentality of Cameroonians and educate Cameroonians on good behavior, good governance, and on good patriotism for a nation. We are coming with a lot of activities that would drill the Cameroonians the way they're supposed to build up a nation. And when you look at it around, we are coming with democracy. In our own governance, you will be free to talk in Cameroon at any time. You are free to express yourself. You're free to talk to the president. You're free to rebuke a president. You're free to question the administration. You're free to talk at any time. Because we, people of light and transparency, there's nothing we'll be hiding. Everything will be open to Cameroonians. I, by the grace of God, the president of Cameroon, I'll be briefing the Cameroonians every month, maybe every week. They'll be hearing my voice at all times. If there's a problem, I will come to assist immediately. I am informed. I'll be very close to my people. We will be very close together. And that is how a president is supposed to be closer to his people. Hear, see the way his people live, feel the way his people live. And a president is made to work for his people, not the people working for him. Thank you. We have a very wonderful program because since we are bringing talking of peace, we are a community of peace. We are bringing peace. And to talk about peace, madam, it's very important that we underline certain facts. You cannot talk of peace without uniting the elements of peace together. It will not work. You cannot talk of peace when somebody is not working, is not have a job, people are hungry, and you know, they have a lot of shortcomings because of a governance that has not been well done in the nation. You can talk of peace. So we are bringing in a lot of elements like industrialization. We are going to industrialize Cameroon because where the Cameroon government has not really reached out and has made some errors is because they have not long time looked at the future of Cameroon in terms of economy. The Cameroonian government has not taken time to know that, okay, in the next future, what are they going to face as the economy is concerned? They were now basically looking at taxation as the only source of funding the government. And when you look at it clearly, you will see that that's where it has plunged Cameroon into a problem because as they are depending only on taxes coming from the private sector, day by day, the financial needs of the government is also increasing. They need finances to meet up with the different demands of governance. And where do they get the finances? They only have to turn to the private sector for taxes. That is the only source of income they have. They only turn there to increase taxes, take the pressure from the financial demands that is rising in government, and ploy back the pressure on the private sector to make sure that they increase the taxes and to satisfy their financial needs. Come a bit. When this is happening, you will see that too much taxes, companies are closing down. The ones that are functioning, they have hard running system. They cannot function well. And people are becoming jobless and jobless because of this very system. And to make it very much clear, you see that if I have walked around nations of the earth, I've been to America many times. I've been to many countries in Europe, in Africa. I've seen how economies of nations are being run by the government. A serious government does not sleep. They work day and night to make sure that they industrialize even themselves so that they can have enough funding for the government. It's government that builds streets. It's government that builds nations. It's serious government is them that organize all these things and make things work for the private sector. By so doing, if the government is well funded by its own investment, sorry to say, our own investments are instead sold out. They've sold out the different state companies, the different state institutions that were even kept in place by Ahijo. They were already sold out. We want more of this in the side of government. We want more investment for the government so that it can better fund the government, and we will come now to the private sector, pull down the taxes. Because we taxes will not really mean much to us. We're going to pull down the taxes because we have enough funding from our investments. Taxes is just a supporting factor as finances and funding the government is concerned. So in the private sector, when we pull down the taxes, there's going to be a giant investment system that will go on there. It will encourage investors locally and nationally to come and invest in the private sector, and that's how the economy will start booming now. Because we are moving forward to a system whereby we want our Cameroonian community, loud and clear, you'll be paid per hour in the nation here. And we have already rated it in a short while, the Cameroonian will be paid per hour. Any hour input in Cameroon, you'll be paid so well. And when you work 8 hours a day, you should be counting some money for yourself. To the least worker, we will make sure that this happens because we're going to work harder, the government. We're going to work harder to make sure that taxes are pulled down in the private sector so that even when we are implementing this payment system for Cameroonians, because of the love we have for the Cameroonian population, nobody should complain because your taxes is not a hindrance. We're going to facilitate functionality in the private sector for the companies and the investors that are around so that it can function well. And make sure that everybody have a job and make sure that they pay our Cameroonian people so well. And that is our policy that we are bringing. And by so doing, if people are working, they have good salaries, they have good jobs, they live well. I don't think you can talk of disparity in Cameroon, differentiations in Cameroon. You can talk of that. We can only talk of a united Cameroon and a Cameroon that is having a good life. Coalition for me is a good thing. Unity is good, but it is the factors that are going to govern the coalition that we need to look at them, because each candidate has his own ideology about how he's looking at governance, and now nobody will really accept, as I've just sought some ideas within some, nobody will really accept to like go under somebody. I don't think so. I don't think that's what will happen. But for me, coalition is a very good thing. But are people ready to go under the others? So that is the problem there.